This is what myosin looks like in a skeletal muscle cell. There's a bare region, and then projecting in both directions from that bare region are myosin monomers with their heads projecting away from or out of the filament itself. The myosin-thick filament is a polymer of many myosin monomers. Each myosin monomer has two heads, the two structures at the left in this illustration. And now we can see what a myosin monomer looks like in the electron microscope after it has been isolated and dissociated from myosin-thick filaments. So we recognize heads and a tail segment. We can dissect the myosin monomer into parts. We can separate the heads and tails using specific proteolytic enzymes. Now remember that myosin-thick filaments are made of proteins, and each myosin monomer is made of two separate proteins, and they are subject to proteolysis, that is, hydrolysis by enzymes that can catalyze the hydrolysis water addition across peptide bonds. And there are some proteolytic enzymes that will catalyze hydrolysis quite specifically between particular amino acids. And when some of these are used, you can generate fragments of the myosin monomer. And here are two fragments that one might generate. One that consists just of the head region, with the two heads still attached to one another, wound around one another, and the tail region. And that would be these regions in this illustration here. The EM pictures are not actually showing chopped up myosin monomers. I have chopped them up to show you the region that they represent based on the picture at the upper part of this slide. The head region is called the S1 head.